The following program is brought to you by friends and faithful covenant partners of Rivers of Living Water Ministries. God bless you.
Hello, I welcome you to our service and thank you for watching. The message you are about to hear is deliver him from going into the pit. Who is a deliverer? Jesus Christ. Who is the deliverance for? For you. Deliverance is children's bread, especially when the Lord himself has promised in Joel 2:32, and it shall come to pass that whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be delivered. For in Mount Zion and in Jerusalem there is deliverance, as the Lord has said. He cannot lie. And because the Lord said it, that settles the matter. Join us in the service to hear the revelational knowledge of this message.
God is key to maintaining your total freedom. Let's join Pastor Amanda Ogunro of the Rivers of Living Waters Ministries for today's message. God bless you as you listen.
Oh, Heavenly Father, I know the heaven is open and is rejoicing with us. Thanking you for such a day like this. Heaven came down. Lord, we are asking and praying that the message we are about to hear, Lord, will bring absolutely, expressly, deliverance to everyone in this assembly and those watching by television. Distance is not a barrier to deliverance. Lord, I pray that your divine presence, oh Lord, will be so thick. It has already started. Father, let it be throughout the whole services. Touch everyone here. Break every band loose and set your people free. Because the ransom is already here. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Today I want to talk to you about deliver him from going down to the pit. Deliver him from going down into the pit. Part two of our series on Jesus is my ransom. Hallelujah. Let's quickly examine Daniel chapter 6. That's where I'm taking my text from. Daniel chapter 6. We'll look at it from verses 3, 7 to 28. Then this Daniel was preferred above the president and princes because an excellent spirit was in him. And the king thought to set him over the whole realm. Go to verse 7. It's quite long. All the president of the kingdom, the governors and the princes, the counselors and the captains have consulted together to establish a royal statute and to make a firm decree that whosoever shall ask a petition of any god or man for 30 days, save of thee, O king, he shall be cast into the den of lions. Now, O king, establish the decree and sign the writing that may not be changed, according to the law of Medes and Persians, which uttereth not. Wherefore, King Darius signed the writing and the decree. Now, when Daniel knew that the writing was signed, he went into his house, and his windows being open in his chamber towards Jerusalem, he kneeled upon his knees 3 times a day and prayed and gave thanks before his God as he did aforetime. Underline aforetime. I refuse to be immovable. I am not shaken by the decree. I will continue to do what I was doing with my God. Then these men assembled and found Daniel praying and making supplication before his God. Then they came in and spake before the king concerning the king's decree. Hast thou not signed a decree that every man that shall ask a petition of any god or man within 30 days, save of thee, O king, shall be cast into the den of lions? The king answered and said, the thing is true, according to the law of the Medes and Persians, which uttereth not. Then answered they and said before the king, that Daniel, which is of the children of captivity of Judah, regarded not thee, O king, nor the decree that thou hast signed, but maketh his petition 3 times a day. Then the king, when he heard these words, was so displeased with himself, and set his heart on Daniel to deliver him. And he labored till going down of the sun to deliver him. Then these men assembled unto the king and said unto the king, know, O king, that the law of the Medes and Persians is that no decree nor statute which the king established may be changed. Then the king commanded, and they brought Daniel and cast him into the den of lions. Now the king spake and said unto Daniel, thy God whom thou servest continually, he will deliver thee.
Amen.
That verse 16 just explained that Darius was innocent. And a stone was brought and laid upon the mount of the den, and the king sealed it with his own singlet and with the singlet of his lords, for the purpose might not be changed concerning Daniel. Then the king went to his palace, passed the night ward, fasting. Then there were instruments of music brought before him, and his sleep ward went from him. As you hear this message, your enemy's sleep will go away from them. In the name of Jesus. Music cannot change, because there is no peace unto the wicked. Then the king arose very early in the morning and went in haste unto the den of lions. And when he came to the den, he cried with a lamentable voice unto Daniel. And the king spake and said to Daniel, O Daniel, servant of the living God, is thy God whom thou servest continually able to deliver thee from the lions? Then said Daniel unto the king, O king, live forever. My God has sent his angel and has shut the lion's mouth, that they have not hurt me. For as much as before him innocency was found in me, underline innocency, and also before thee, O God, I have done no hurt. Then was the king exceedingly glad for him, and commanded that they should take Daniel up out of the den. So Daniel was taken up out of the den, and no manner of hurt was found upon him, because he believed in his God. And the king commanded, and they brought those men which had accused Daniel, and they cast them into the den of lions, them, their children, and their wives. And the lions had mastery of them, and break all their bones in pieces. However, they came at the bottom of the den. Then the king Darius wrote unto all people, nations, and languages that dwell in all the earth, peace be multiplied unto you. I make a decree that in every dominion of my kingdom, men tremble and fear before the God of Daniel.
Hallelujah.
For he is the living God, and steadfast forever, and his kingdom, that we shall not be destroyed, and his dominion shall be even unto the end.
Amen.
He delivereth and rescueth, and worketh signs and wonders in heaven and in earth, who had delivered Daniel from the power of lions. So Daniel prospered in the reign of Darius and in the reign of Cyrus the Persian. Amen. There is a man, that's Daniel, from Judah, one of the captivities by the Babylonians. And because of God's favor, goodness, grace upon him, there has to be a distinction. And King Darius so much loved this man, because when the favor of God is upon your life, everything about you is unique. Everywhere you go, people fall in love with you. Everywhere you go, the door that is closed, as you approach the door, it opens on its own accord. And eventually, the king called the presidents, princes, the counselors, the governors, that it's not that I'm going to put up, will be your head. You be your leader. They were not happy. Not even the one of the Babylonians, a captive, to come and start reigning over us. So what are we going to do? Be careful. They checked everything. How are we going? What will you use to accuse this man? They could not find anything. They said, okay, the only way we can accuse him is to stop him not to pray. And we know he cannot do without prayer. Prayer is his life. So they went to the king, wrote a decree, and make him to sign it with the lords and the president. The decree was that anyone who will pray within 30 days will be thrown into the lion's den. Daniel knew about it. He heard it. He just said, praise the Lord. Daniel said, praise the Lord. He said, there's another promotion to go higher and higher. If God be for me, you can be against me. He just went again, opened the window to Jerusalem, and went on his knees. They came, they saw him, they said, thank God. When the enemy, they are saying, thank God, they are winning, their destruction is so close.
Amen.
So went to the king Darius and said, are you not the one who made this decree? We have found this man again, he's praying. And immediately the king heard that, he was not happy. He was brainwashed. He didn't know the truth, that they were plotting evil against this man because of jealousy. And eventually, the king had already signed. Once he signed, and the other lords with him signed, nobody can change it without his authorization. And eventually, he said, okay, I want to cast him into the lion's den. He didn't just say that. He went to Daniel. He said, Daniel, that God you serve, I hope he will deliver you. He didn't say the God you serve. I made a mistake. The God that you continually serve, not occasionally, continually, persistency, constancy is so important to God. And then they threw him in. But they've forgotten that Daniel was from the land of Judah. And in the land of Judah, there is a king that ruled all over the world. His name is the Lion of the tribe of Judah. So they now threw him into the lion's den. Also, remember, as they were preparing to throw him, God was waiting so that they can throw him. What are you going through today in your life? I believe that God is watching the enemy, waiting. Say, by the time I finish with you, you wish you never even go near my daughter. You didn't even go near my sons. And then he landed. As he was landing, the lion, they already made a bed. They arranged themselves. When you say lion, then they are over 100. Not one or two. Then the dens of lion, they may be up to 1,000. The lion just make a bed, may use themselves to make a bed. Another become a pillow. They say, welcome, sir. Welcome home. You are a king. You are from the lion of tribe of Judah. And we are under you. What do you want to eat? Because lion, they don't eat lion. Lion, they can eat ordinary animal, but they don't eat lion. Lion never eat lion. And then they said, what do you want to eat, sir? He said, I'm not hungry yet. When I'm ready, I'll let you know. He was enjoying himself with the lions. And after the following day, the king came, and the conspirators, they were so happy that by the time they brought him, I was already dead, not knowing that his name would go in his stead. The king could not sleep. The music, he said, he does not want to hear any music. He knew that this man was innocent. And eventually, he came to the den. He said, Daniel, are you still alive? Daniel said, fine. Not to say, I'm okay, I'm enjoying myself. I'm in the company of my people here. Can you just leave me here? He said, no, come up. Because some people, they brought him out. When they brought him out, not a single hurt. And then immediately, he came out of the den. The lions now got up and became lion to eat. But what are the reasons? Why is it that the lion could not eat this man? Number one, he has an excellent spirit. The spirit that is different from the Babylonian spirit. The Babylonians, they are idol worshippers. So the spirit of devil is in them. An excellent spirit is an extraordinary spirit with diligence, with intelligence. And immediately, King Darius saw this in this man. He has respect for him. The spirit of excellency. That's what Daniel 6:3 says. And that spirit, who could that spirit be? The Holy Spirit. When the Spirit of God is upon you, there are things you do, you don't even understand why you are doing them. And people will compliment and say, this thing is excellent because of the spirit of excellence. And number two, Daniel was innocent. He was victimized because of Darius' favor upon him. Especially now they want to give him a new, the highest posts in Babylon. And because he was innocent, the Lord also what? Delivered him. Number three, he trusted in his God. Psalm 1:5, 1-3 said, they that trust in the Lord shall be as Mount Zion, which shall not be removed, but abide forever. As the mountain is round about Jerusalem, so the Lord is round about his people, henceforth and forevermore. That's what he says. He said, the rod of the wicked shall not rest upon the lot of the righteous, lest they put their hand into iniquity. And there is no iniquity found in Daniel. And therefore, he was not guilty to die by lions. Amen. Number four, he was delivered from the pit. Why his conspirators, they went into the pit? Go to Proverbs 11, we'll look at verse 8. The righteous is delivered out of trouble, and the wicked cometh in his stead. Say a bigger amen. Amen. What is a pit? We all know that a pit is a hole, and we can also say a pit that is a hole has diverse sizes. All holes are not the same. Depending on the purpose you dug the hole for. Grave is a pit, but you cannot dug it for well. You have a well of water, it's pit, the dog. The well of water, we saw it in Genesis chapter 26. Let's look at it. I'm teaching this morning, I'm not preaching. Let's go quickly to the scriptures. Look at verse 18. And Isaac digged again the wells of water, which they had digged in the days of Abraham his father. For the Philistines had stopped them after the death of Abraham, and he called their names after the names by which his father had called them. That's a pit for water. And then you also have a pit for immorality, for fornication. Let's go to Proverbs chapter 23. Proverbs chapter 23. I'm not the one talking. It's the Lord talking to you. Proverbs 23:27 says, for a hole is a deep ditch. What's a ditch? It's a hole. Deep ditch. A hole, a prostitute. For a hole is a deep ditch. And a strange woman is what? A narrow pit. That's God talking. That's the definition. What immorality will do to you. It's not enjoyment. It's death. It's a trap. That's what Proverbs is telling us, Proverbs 23:27. That is immorality. You still have time to repent and come out of it. We don't want you to die before your time. He said, why should you die before your time? You also have a pit of death. We saw it in Daniel 6:16, our text. It was thrown to the lions, and that's a pit of death. You have a pit of death. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. There are three kinds of pits. The visible pit and the invisible pit and the self-dug pit. I'll repeat that again. You have the visible pits You have the invisible pit and you have self-dug pits, which means you dig a pit, you want to fall into yourself. We all know the visible pit, the well and etc. Abraham dug a well, whatever, that's visible pit for a purpose. The purpose is water. You also have grave. The purpose of grave is to bury somebody dead. Every whole dog has a purpose. Now, the invisible pit is the one Satan dug for you without your knowledge, which can come in diverse forms. It can come in form of sickness. It can come in form of poverty. It can come in form of anger. It can come in form of fear. That's a pit on its own. And then you have self-dug pit. The meaning of that is that you know what will kill you before your time, and you are still doing it. You are digging a pit. He that diggeth a pit, what happened? Ecclesiastes 10:8. You know that if you smoke tobacco or cigarette or whatever name they call it, you will die of lung cancer. And you smoke 10 packets, even 20 a day. And you know if you drink too much alcohol, you die of liver cirrhosis, cancer of the liver. And if you know you eat a lot of junks, donuts, meat pie, they are junks. The reason why I use the word junks is not, doesn't profit the body. It's sweet mouth, but there's nothing to nourish you. You know, we are created human beings, but the way our body reacts to things, they are different. There are some that we eat and eat and eat, they don't have problem. But we cannot copy them because we don't know their system. Then what are you to watch out for? Your food. This one has nothing to do with demons. You are eating too much fatty things. That's why I call it self-dug pit. Hallelujah. Who can be delivered? Who? Only the righteous. Let's go to Psalm 34. Psalm 34, look at verse 7. It said, the angel of the Lord encampeth round about them that fear him and delivered them. In other words, we have to fear the Lord. And then you go to 17. It said, the righteous cry, and the Lord heareth, and delivereth them out of all their troubles. It didn't say the wicked cried. Only the righteous are cried that he will hear. Go to 19. Many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord delivereth them out of them all. So if you are undergoing a lot of afflictions and etc., congratulations, the Lord said, I will deliver you from all of them. Amen. Who can be delivered? Those who the Lord delight in. This is a special grace I'm talking about. And then those who are found innocent. Remember, God could not kill Abimelech. Because he was innocent, Abraham lied and said, my wife is my sister. And it was not his sister. And then Abimelech now said they should bring the wife, wanted to marry her. And God intervened and went straight to him in a sleep and said, Abimelech, you are a dead man. You better return this woman to her husband. Her husband is a prophet. And Abimelech said, God, I'm innocent. Will you kill an innocent man? Said, I know. You are innocent. And innocency, you did what you did. You didn't know. But now that you know, I'm telling you now, if you don't do it, everything to do with you, I will kill every one of them. And quickly send his wife Sarah, not only just Sarah, he packed all the goods so that God will be happy. Innocence. If you are innocent, God will deliver you. Amen. The scripture is Daniel 6:22 and then Psalm 18:23. How do we come out of the pit? How to come out of the pit? How? Number one, you must believe the word of God and speak the word of God. Remember, the word you speak is so important. Mark 11:23-24. Then number two, have faith in God and his word. Hebrews 11:6. Psalm 9:15. Number three, pray with revelation knowledge. Daniel 2:22. Number four, use the blood of Jesus. 1 Thessalonians 5:17 and Revelation 12:11. Number five, the anointing. Isaiah 10:27. If we are in this assembly, we have not given our life to Jesus Christ, this is an opportunity now to come and give your life to Christ. And viewers by television, it's an opportunity. If yes, can you stand up, repeat after me? Lord Jesus, just want to thank you for your mercy upon my life. I come to you as a sinner. I confess my sins to you and I ask for mercy. Forgive my sins, I remember them no more. Wash me with your precious blood. Cleanse me from all unrighteousness. Today I invite you into my heart and I receive you as my Lord and personal Savior. Lord Jesus, come into me. Lord Jesus, come into my heart and stay. Fill my heart with the Holy Spirit. And give me the grace to live a life without sin. Write my name in the book of life. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Son. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for I'm born again in Jesus' name. Oh, Heavenly Father, we just thank you for the souls that have come back home. We pray, Lord, that your mighty eyes will be upon them and the Holy Spirit will continue to lead them and guide them throughout the rest of their stay here on earth. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen and amen.
Congratulations on your new journey to gaining total freedom. Kindly contact us for a free copy of Pastor Amanda Ogunro's book, The Greatest Miracle.
I believe you have been blessed by this message. It's a powerful teaching. Job 33:24 declares, said, then he is gracious unto him, saying, deliver him from going into the pits. I have found a ransom. Who is your ransom? Jesus Christ. What did he use to ransom you? His blood that was shed on the cross of Calvary for you and for me. And therefore, knowing this, it's your responsibility not to accept captivity. What you need to do is to attack any bondage, any form of bondages you are in. Is it poverty? Is it barrenness? Is it sickness? You should not accept it. The Lord said, it is finished. John 19:30. Whatever the Lord says should be your portion in Jesus' name. This Amanda Ogunro saying to you, continue to watch Total Freedom. We love you. Till next time, God bless you. Bye-bye.
I believe you've been blessed by this message. And if you need more of our messages, please kindly contact us at number 540 Ikorodu Road, Maryland, Lagos.
Or call us on these numbers, 0909-462-8309 or 0903-496-493 and 0705-02-19571.
Or email us at info@rlwm.org. God bless you.